The word isn't complete. It's missing a piece. The door is shut. If memory serves, we'll need to light both of those torches to open it. This is a mystic fire. Its flames are short-lived. Oof! That's it.
While the Noken lives, let's go find it!
There. I see the chalice.
From the ceremony.
A symbol of reconciliation. We drank from the lover's chalice until we could hardly stand. I confided in him that night about wanting an apology from Freyr. Odin reassured me that he'd be the only family I'd need. And I believed him. It's a denouncement from my people, placed during my wedding. The word is complete, but I still can't read it from here. Let's head back down.
Better now?
No. The pain only grows. Will I never be free of it? What more do I need to do? The runic word appeared over there. See it?
Fluka.
After all the battles I've fought, why does the other side of this door scare me most?
The most difficult battles are fought within. But this battle, you will not fight alone. Are you ready?
There it is. My final tie to Asgard. We drove that sword into the pillar together. The sword was forged for the ceremony. A symbol of our union. Molna.
The stone refuses to let go.
The deepest wounds form the strongest bonds. Bastard said it as part of our vows. I hate it when he's right. Asgard holds a part of me I can't sever. My bond to my son. To the Valkyries. That damn realm isn't just Odin's. It belongs to me, too. The pain he caused is his. I refuse to keep holding on to it. This sword no longer holds our legacy. But it will serve as mine.
A much more fitting use for it. Anything interesting, brother?
I suppose it's on to the next battle now.
Yes. You won an important one today.
Since when have you ever asked for permission?
It's just... I owe you my life, such as it is, and I caused you so much pain, put you in a terrible situation. For that, Freya, I am truly sorry.
I wanted to end that war, too.
I know. But I swear to do better by you nonetheless. Anything you ask, consider it done. I'm forever in your debt.
I appreciate that. Even if you can't help being an obnoxious know-it-all.
I'm afraid I'll never know how to stop doing that, Your Majesty.
Ha!
You know, an arrogant man once told me you can't change the past, only how it shapes you. I think he might be right. It's been a while since I've had a confidant. Would the god of few words lend me his ear now and again?
As long as I am needed.
Force of habit, I suppose, since I don't sleep anymore. Although, it's far more confounding that I'm the tired one. I've seen you stay awake for days at a time without so much as a drooping eyelid. Not even a nap.
Gods do not nap.
Oh, tell that to Thor.
Can't believe we missed this.
Munda. Would you happen to know how your light and dark elf friends came to be involved?
You mean Bayfair and Bela? Well, they were both in prison by one side or another, or maybe both. Escaped together, been on the run, and absolutely all over each other ever since.
A dark and light elf fleeing their people together. Quite a risk.
Being in love's always a risk. That's what makes it fun.
You could say the same about hot cheese.
Linda, what do you know of Birger the Traveler?
Not much. I ain't the talking type, really. But from what I can glean, he walked the path of the Traveler for a time, then found out something that made him step off it. Car.
Any idea what he saw?
No, I'm not sure, but I think he saw what was at the end of the path. And, didn't care much for it.
Finding out Odin was pulling their strings all along probably put a colossal kink in his codpiece.
Hiya, Freya! How you doing?
I'm fine.
On that, madam, we are agreed.
What? Oh. Oh, thank you?
Anytime.
Ha! Linda, you ain't changed one damn bit. And now for the goddess. Big man?
Well, brother, before you see the lad again, might we discuss an approach?
He will tell me where he has been. That is my approach.
Ah, classic Spartan diplomacy.
Wait. Did you say Odin invited him to Asgard, and then he disappeared for 2 days?
Aye.
But surely the lad's got more sense than to-
Don't underestimate Odin's powers of persuasion. He filled my son's head with lies. Why wouldn't he do the same with yours?
And you tell that one-eyed nutsucker he owes me one!
Thank me now and eternally!
Well, looky there. Glad you can make the trip, your goddessness. I put your sigil magic on the young turd's bow. But then he insin- He got into it over something. I don't rightly know who's yelling at who in there, but I figure they-
Hello! Good to see the chimes.
Who else are we likely to encounter amongst your detachable emotional apparitions?
Well, there's certainly no avoiding anxiety.
Oh, no. Why are you talking about me? What did I do?
Oh, you should have heard the shit they were talking.
What? Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
There was no such talk. Shame on you, Bitter.
Are you sure?
Yes, Anxious. No opprobrium to be found in this discourse. I was merely making your acquaintance with our adventuring friends here.
Ah! People!
Well, there it is. Well, good luck out there.
Talking squirrels now, huh?
We'll be back, Brock. Alfheim, what's there?
We still have unfinished business there. Last we were in Alfheim, Atreus heard something out in the Barrens. Creature in terrible pain.
Lead the way.
I must say, I think we make a good team. With my brains, Kratos' brawn, and my lady's,
Wisdom? Magic? Ability to tolerate you for long periods of time?
I was going to say brutality.
That works.
Another raven sent to the Tree of the Dead. Perhaps we should check up on it, hmm?
Hail, fellow travelers!
Atreus heard a creature in pain in the desert.
Over a storm like this? Most impressive.
When I was Atreus's age, this desert was home to all manner of life. Have you seen any large creatures in your travels out here?
No, sorry. The elves and I... Long story, but it's best when we keep out of each other's way. Hive matter is stickier than I care for. Good luck on your search, though. Stuff some cloth in your ears to keep the sand out. Don't knock it till you've tried it.
Gulon in Alfheim.
And sled trained by the looks of it. Most unusual.
I've never seen such obedience in Gulon. There is some kind of magic at work here.
Regardless, it should make desert travel downright pleasant. Were it not for a brutal sandstorm. Any particular direction to find your wounded animal? Or are we just enjoying the weather?
How do you hope to find anything in all this?
Perhaps we find a cave first to get our bearings?
Look there! An entrance to the caves!
This cave extends underneath the desert.
Aye. A refuge for the Dark Elves, by the looks of it. One of the few remaining now that they're barred from the temple. Perhaps we'll find Atreus's wounded animal down here.
Lead the way, Kratos. I trust you to not get us lost underground.
Rocks!
lashing out at everything and everyone for their fate.
They will not listen to reason. Combat is unavoidable.
Trust me, I know. Still, I wish it were not the case.
Patience. A virtue or a threat?
Depends on the reader.
Strange how you'd rather bring me along for this task instead of your own son.
I have to agree, brother. Atreus would have enjoyed this desert dalliance, especially where maimed innocent creatures in need of rescue are concerned.
Good. Perhaps it will teach him the consequences of disobedience.
An odd way to discipline. I am in no position to judge.
Bastards about to explode!